Now, yesterday, Cryptic released the information about the ship that we are going to cover, the Titan Science Destroyer. Channel subscription is also available on my awesome channel. If you want to support the content that I'm making and me personally, this is how you can do this. So I made the video yesterday about the Titan Science Destroyer, and where I covered like all of the statistics, all of the backstory that Cryptic usually provides for us to understand what this ship is all about and how it came to be. So I'm not going to do that. I'm going to change the format a little bit. I normally go out through all of the information on this video, but then the video tends to be a little bit longer on the long side. So I'm going to cut that out. If you really are interested in the details, the statistics, I'm going to cover, I'm going to copy paste them in the video description as it is written on Cryptic's main page. If it is updated later, nerfed or changed down the line, you can thank Cryptic for that. Hopefully not. But anyway, today we're going to cover the Titan Science Destroyer. Now, this is definitely a new ship in the game. It is just being released as it is right now. It is available on the Cryptic's Zen store, basically this is where all of the Zen items are. They're their own store in the game, basically. Now I do also want to mention that during the whole Black Friday thing, they basically have made it so everything, you know, everything is on sale. There is like a big, huge discount in almost everything. I don't want to say everything, but there is some kind of like, you know, either it is like 25% or 50%, 30%. There is like a very large selection for you to, if you want to buy stuff, you can do that right now due to the whole Black Friday deal that's going on. So today, the Titan Science Destroyer. Now, I do have a coupon to, you know, to basically claim this thing for free, but this is, there is a little bit of a bug right here, but this is the ship that we are going to cover. Now, I do apologize for being taking a little bit long to getting here, but this is the USS Titan. This is how it looks like from the sides, from the top, from the front, and I'm basically going to use no coupon because there is already a 25% discount on this. Normally it's going to cost 3,000 Zen. Now it is only 25%. So it's only going to cost me 2,250 Zen. So that's all right with me. Now I do want to mention that everything on the Zen store item that you're, mostly everything that you buy on the Zen store items are account unlocks. Unless, you know, stated otherwise in the description. So I am definitely going to buy this right here without any discount. There it is. Eager? Okay, eager. This thing is eager. But I'm going to make it my current Starship and head over to the customization, see what kind of customization we can do. I'm definitely interested in the deflector dish. Somebody on Discord said that when you're in different modes, science and tactical, this thing is also going to change color. Who knows? I'll be right back. So here we are at the NPC where you basically have your own Starship selections, or at least the ships that you have unlocked on your account. You can select them. Now, this is the Titan Science Destroyer as it is right now. Now, this is not the fleet variant. The fleet variant is basically going to get an extra science console slot and 10% hull hit points and shield hit points in addition to the normal statistics that this thing comes with. But this is how it looks like. Now, you can also upgrade it to the tier 6 X, and also I believe some of you, or at least one of you, actually comment on the video that you can also upgrade the fleet variant. I was kind of wondering about that. Can you actually upgrade the fleet variant chips to a fleet tier 6 X? It's kind of a mouthful to say, but based on what the guys, what you guys are saying in the comment section, you can definitely upgrade that. So you're going to get, with the fleet variant, you're going to get basically the normal ship, only 5 science console slots, 4 tactical console slots, 2 engineering, and in addition, a universal console slot. So basically giving you 12 console slots. So that's definitely a thumbs up for if you want to buy the fleet variant. But I'm going to show you guys if you upgrade it. So this window is going to pop up. So this is what you're going to get. Definitely a name change or class change, tier 6X with an extra device slots, a universal console slot, and you're also going to get an addition of, it's going to allow you to basically choose an extra console slot whenever you are flying the USS, or at least mine is called the Eager. But it's going to be whenever you're going to fly the upgraded version, so the tier 6X, it's going to allow you to choose an additional trait that you're going to be able to slot in your ship. Now I do want to show it to you guys. So normally you're going to get like 5, and if you unlock it, you're going to get an extra one, so a 6th trait, just from, you know, upgrading your ship to tier 6-X. All right, so this one is my current Starship. Now I'm going to head over to here to customize my Starship. Now, this is how it looks like. Wow. Okay. Is this the Luna? Okay, this is the Luna class. I don't know. Is this ship in the game? I have not seen this ship in the game, to be honest. Or maybe the ship is in the game and I've like never flown it before. The Polar. Whoa. This thing is spiked. What? What is this? I don't think these ships are in the game. Or at least this particular ship is in the game, but these different variants of these ships, I like it. It kind of looks like icicles. Nice. Soul. What the hell is this? There is a bump up here. Is this like the command center, basically, because they don't have the deflector dish housing on top and they can't see up here? But they also have the deflector dish underneath. This is weird. You guys are probably in the comment section already saying that either we do or we don't have these ships in the game, but... And this is the Titan. I don't think we have the Luna in the... Or maybe we do. My mind is blown right now. I don't remember this particular ship in the game. Anyway, this video is about the Titan, guys. So this is how it looks like. I can't go any, you know, zooming any further than this. So we have a top view. We have a front view. Left, right. And the rear and the bottom one. I like it. If you fly it upside down, it's like the normal traditional saucer section and the warp nacelles, but this is how it's meant to be flown. I like it. So it has the secondary deflector dish housing right on top, normal deflector dish right here. I like it a lot. Anyway, you can definitely mismatch different components right here with the whole section. I'm going to nacelles. So you can change them up like that. Nice. I like that. The mission. Oh, the thing is called a mission pod. I didn't know that it was called a mission pod, but this thing is... This is what's called like the secondary deflector dish housing, like that's on top. It's called the mission pod. Nice. All right. Let me show you the different material types. So you got the Defiant one over here. All right. The Galaxy. The Intrepid. Luna. The Luna. I never seen a Luna. Maybe. I don't know. NX right here. NX retrofit. Or refit, sorry. The Sovereign. I am going a little bit fast on these because these are just the cosmetic. These are not changing anything to the shape of the ship anymore. These are just the different like material types, basically the whole plating. We got Type 0, so basically Kirk's Enterprise themed. Type 1 up here. These are basically the old ones. Type 2, the ones that I really don't like. Type 3. Okay. Type 4. Not into that. Type 5, sorry. I was about to say 6. 6 is now a little bit really, really bright. Really lots of bloom going on. 7, this is how it came out of the box, out of the Zen store, out of the, well, what did I pay? Like 2,250. Type 8. Oh, I like 8 as well. It's a little too bright. It's too bright in here. But it works. 8B. That also works. That works for me as well. You have the upgraded material type. And also the veteran. Oh, the veteran. I love the veteran. I almost want to do this whole review on the veteran class. Because it's, or at least with the veteran materials. Because it's so good. But I can't. I have to do it on type 7. Because that is how it came out of the box. Now, I am going to load up another character of mine. Another account, I should say. To give you guys a comparison. And that's going to be the Lucari science ship. So I'll be right back again. So how I normally do these reviews. I also show you guys the starship comparison against another ship. Now, in this time, we're going to do the Lucari science ship. Because as size comparison. As like the ship that we're going to compare the ship. In the normal statistics, we don't see how big this ship is. So we kind of need to look over to the books and all that good stuff, but it is what it is. We don't have any information about the length of the ship, or at least I've not seen it being posted anywhere on the blog post, but it is what it is. This is how big it is in the game if you compare it to the Lucari science ship. Some of you call it the Dorito ship. The triangle, whatever you guys are calling it these days. But it is in size basically twice as big as the other one, the Lucari science ship. And it flies good. It flies good. Even though it is kind of like flat out. It is very like, you know, as ships go. You guys like the, I don't know. I don't know if I'm liking the ship, to be honest, but it's like, it is good. It is good. I'm liking it. I'm liking it. No difference in whatsoever. Now, we do have a tactical mode or a science mode. Normally, this ship is under science mode. So, we do have a mechanics that hopefully is going to change the way the ship looks like. Or at least based on the comment section you guys were talking about. I forgot what was it called again. The engineering part, I believe. I forgot, damn it. Anyway, this thing is going to change based on the comment section, but I don't know. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, click. Oh, it did change. Oh, it did. Wow. The mission pod? Was it called the mission pod? Damn. Oh, that's sick. I like it. I like it a lot. So, in terms of this tactical and science mode, now there is this Dyson Science Destroyer is the one that actually has the same mechanic, also into tactical and, you know, in a different mode. I believe it's also science, on the top of my head. And these warp nacelles are pulsating. You guys see that? Look at now it's like really bright and then it dims back down. There it goes. What? Okay, that's some really cool addition. This mission part is very good. I like it. Now, in terms of the ship, the way it looks, it's not changing. It's not manipulating its form. I believe the Dyson Science Destroyer does that, kind of like changes a little bit based on what kind of mode you were having. Correct me if I'm wrong, but that's what I believe. Now, that ship is like maybe 7 years, 6-7 years that I have not flown that, so it's kind of like really memory, you know. Anyway, so getting back to science mode, I do love that. It's like energizes a little bit. Now, if you also paid attention, we also changed the way that our bridge slots were situated right here. All right, so just giving you guys a little bit of a rundown. So we got four weapons on the front, deflector dish, and a secondary deflector dish based mainly because it is a science heavy ship, and then the normal warp impulse shields and normal stuff. Three weapons on the aft, so four on the front, three on the aft. There is an experimental weapon slot. This was not stated in the blog. I hope this is not a bug, to be honest. Or is this only active when it is on science? No, it's still here. Wow. Okay, so this thing has five on the front, three on the aft, or four and four based on these experimental weapon slots, because normally they are basically 360-degree targeting eyes. So it's kind of like an omnidirectional. Normally they're like based on beams. But I'm liking it, to be honest. Hopefully this is not going to be a bug where Cryptic is going to nerf it back into the normal stuff. We have room for three devices, two engineering console slots, four science, four tactical. The fleet variant is going to get an extra science console slot, so five for science, four for tactical. And if you upgrade this to the tier 6X version, you're going to get a universal console slot. So basically you can slot in everything up there from science, engineering, and tactical just to have, you know, more survivability doing science damage or crowd control, or just, you know, the traditional DPS enhancing consoles. Let's take a look at the mastery. So level 1 is going to give you plus 15 exotic damage abilities, 50%. Level 2 is going to increase your shield hit points by 10%. Level 3, whole healing abilities and shield healing abilities by 10% in increasement in that. Level 4 is going to give you reactive shielding technology and X amount of regeneration every 6 seconds. I say X amount because all of the statistics right here are based upon my character. So if you have, you know, totally different character loadout and basically point spec into like science, as you guys probably know, my skill tree for space is not existent. So that's basically the flat out numbers that you normally are going to get. And it's another enterprise that's going to be the Starship trait that we are going to unlock. This is going to improve your fleet ability. And this is when activated by engineering, tactical, science fleet, summon a ship of your faction's flagship class to join you in combat for the next 90 seconds. Okay, at one time I believe this thing was 60 seconds, but now it's like a minute and a half. Nice, I like it. I like it. What is this? Opening Salvo. This thing is pulsating. Why is it pulsating? That's kind of interesting. This is basically because I'm on tactical mode and this thing wants to fire. Anyway, this is the information where we're going to see the universal console slot. When activating your fire, several salvos of projectile at targets in your forward arc over the several seconds. By default, these projectiles will disable all subsystems on target hit, in addition dealing kinetic based damage. In tactical mode, these projectiles will deal damage in an area of effect on each hit. And additionally, debuff damage resistance to any foes affected, but will no longer disable subsystems. So the only these are definitely tied up to the mode you're in, science or tactical. So keep that in mind. This console also provides a passive boost to Starship Exotic Particle Generator or and Starship Weapon Specialization can be equipped in any slot, any ship, only one of these consoles at any given time. Alright, so EPG right here improves exotic damage by 21.4. Modest amount, not bad, not bad, I like it. And also 21.4 Starship Weapon Specialization, so critical hit chance with weapon. So I was kind of right stating this is going to enhance critical chance on when I did the review yesterday, or at least when I read all of the information on the blog post. So if anybody's willing to watch that video, link in the video description, head back to all of the details that we already know about this particular ship. Opening salvo, spawn the area in front of you with with high damage projectiles. I like that. At maximum of 12, affected foe maximum of 5, 12 kilometer range with a 90 degree cone. So basically 90 degree from your forward arc in a cone shape. 0.5 seconds charge with a 2-minute cooldown. Oh man, 2-minute cooldown for this. X amount of kinetic damage times 4 per target. Ooh, I like that. Knock target subsystem offline for the next 4.5 seconds, only during science mode. Keep that in mind. And skill that affect this ability, Starship Drain Expertise. Now I am going to go to the bridge officers. What kind of mode am I in right now? I think I'm in tactical mode. Yes, this is in tactical mode. So you're going to get a commander tactical station. So everything tactical up there. You get an ensign tactical station. You have a lieutenant engineering right here. You have a commander science station and a lieutenant commander science command station. So I noticed that it's going to change whenever you're in science mode. There it is, it changed. It changed on the bridge officer layout, but it didn't change here on top. We'll have to look at it I'm going to equip all of my bridge officers and take this thing into battle. See what kind of abilities are active or are gone, basically. So it does state right here, I'm in science mode, this thing is not active, so it does give me the fourth ability right here, so it is still a commander tactical station, even though the commander tactical ability on the bridge officer seating is gone. Anyway, give me 2 seconds to grab the Admiralty card for you guys. Some of you actually still find that useful. All right, so this is going to be the Admiralty card. We have a Titan Science Destroyer with 2 stars in its rarity. 15 points in engineering, 41 in tactical, 52 in science. If you want to slot this thing with another tactical ship, you're going to get plus 10 in science per tactical ship. So if you slot it with 2 other tactical ship, tactical ships, you're going to get plus 20 in all of the numbers that you're going to do if you want to do that. Now, what I'm going to do next is I'm going to level this thing all the way to level 5 to unlock the Starship trait. It's another Enterprise, yay! And so I'll be right back, and then we can actually have some fun doing a patrol together so you guys see it a little bit in combat, how it performs. So I'll be right back again. Now, for all of you, it's just like in and out transition, but for me, it was like maybe 20, 30, 40 minutes. I don't know how long 4 patrols actually take these days, but that is how long it took me to level this thing all the way up. A couple of things to note. I wasn't really happy about Ambassador Kale not posting a couple of things on his blog post. Now, I am going to grab the blog post just to reference it up. So there are a couple of things to note. So whenever you're entering the tactical or science mode, depending on which profession, or at least which one you are using at that particular time, the science, or at least the bridge officer ability do change a little bit. And I noticed this in game as well. So if you're already in science mode, you're definitely going to get this commander science bridge officer ability. So the fourth one, you're going to be able to use that. You're not going to be able to use the fourth ability right here whenever you are in science mode from the tactical bridge officer slot. So in my personal or at least in this case, it's going to be, I'm not going to be able to use the Omega pattern, the third version that I'm using currently, whenever I'm in science mode. Now whenever in tactical mode, it's going to be reversed. So whenever you're going to be in tactical mode, you're going to be able to use the fourth ability. So I'm going to be able to use attack pattern Omega, but I'm not going to be able to use gravity well. And that is definitely noticeable up here. You can see that the tactical only has like three abilities instead of the fourth one. And if I switch, it's going to add one ability and it's going to remove the gravity well. So here we go. 3, 2, 1, click. And then the bridge officers reorientate themselves. So I don't have the gravity well anymore, but I do have the Omega attack pattern Omega up here. Now I did look up at the blog post of Ambassador Kale, and I'm going to bring that up right now. So this is the blog post that Ambassador Kale posted yesterday, or basically 2 days ago, because it is on 18th of November. Now, it doesn't state this mechanic anywhere in this blog post. That's basically a letdown for the people that are definitely hyped about this ship, because me, one of them as well. Oh, sorry, I just hit the mic. But I'm definitely hyped about this thing, because it is a new ship, new type of ship in the game, and it has this mechanic, and it's not stated anywhere that you're going to lose and gain a tactical and a science depending on what kind of mode you are on. And the second part that I also want to mention, there is in this entire blog post, there is nothing mentioned about the experimental weapon slot. So if you go over to the details up here, you only see the forward weapons has 4 and the aft 3, and there is nothing else stated about anything related to the experimental weapon slot that we've basically gained up here, including the fleet variant. It's basically the same, just, you know, different statistics, but nothing mentioned about the experimental weapon slot. Now, I do know myself that if the experimental weapon slot was mentioned, people were basically going to buy this ship a little bit earlier, faster, because the experimental weapon slot is definitely something that is going to enhance your traditional DPS. So a lot of people are definitely going to go for, I want that. But he did not mention that. And it's just basically a shame that he went that route. Because, you know, it's just a miss, to, in all honesty. But anyway, moving on. I did unlock the fifth trait up here now back in the game, and I slotted up here. It's another enterprise, so whenever you activate engineering, tactical, or science fleet, that's basically this ability right here. So tactical fleet, because I am a tactical captain, or at least the character is that I'm playing is a tactical, so it is going to use that. It is going to spawn in a different enterprise, or it's another enterprise. So very hyped to show you guys that. Now I am going to do a patrol mission with you guys, and guess what mission we're going to do. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, click. We're definitely going to do the Agala patrol mission, because that is something that you guys are accustomed to from me playing this particular this part of the video, showing you guys how it is done. Now I do want to mention that everything that you guys hear, that you see up here in my video, this is not a build video. This is not how you should build this particular ship, but this is how I build it. It's his personal preference. No real thought has gone into this, And the way I'm building it, it is definitely doing some damage to these guys. Now, I do have a couple of command abilities. You guys see concentrate firepower right here. I have, I don't know what this thing is called, a rally point marker. So whenever you are in the vicinity, or at least inside this area up here, you're definitely going to get a little bit of hull healing, shield healing as well. Yeah, shield restoration and hull restoration. So, you know, it is definitely like a safe spot. I've also equipped a couple of really good stuff, but you guys are mostly interested in this opening salvo. So here you go, 3, 2, 1, and then click. And this is so what it does. It basically fires torpedoes, and it just debuffed like crazy these guys. Now keep in mind that this is only going to be on a cone shape whenever you are going to be in the forward arc. Now I'm just doing some traditional stuff, some normal, not a lot of like DPS, because I really don't intend these videos to be DPS oriented. I don't want you guys to be here for DPS. I want you guys to be here just so I can show you guys the ships, how they come out of the box. No real enhancement has been done. I'm going to show you guys this. So these are the weapons that I'm using. These are just plain weapons that you get from the fleet. This has not been upgraded. These are not being re-engineered any way, form, or, you know, just some random mods. We got crit D, damage times 3, accuracy mod, crit D again, dark matter, quantum torpedo, just the normal stuff. Nothing has been enhanced. I do have a couple of universal consoles, but that's about it. Nothing has been updated up here. Now I am pressing all of my buttons at once, and we missed it. I activated this thing on man, so we kind of need to wait a little bit, 3 minutes, to see our ship's flagship. That's gonna be up here, but anyway, we can definitely kill all these guys by doing our things. So that guy's dead. Now, things that I'm kind of mentioning, and I'm kind of harsh on Ambassador Kale, but you know, that is basically the only source of information that we get before we buy the ship, right? Before we actually see what the ship is all about, is those blog posts. And not for, you know, for him not to mention like an extra experimental weapon slot and the whole mechanics, tactical and science mode. That's just, you know, that's just in my book not a really complete picture of what you're basically going to get for 3000 Zen, even though it's kind of like on a discount that we bought it. But so we kind of need to wait 2 minutes for this skill to be completed. You know what, I'm gonna cut the video. You guys are not gonna wait here to another minute. All right, so it's gonna be about 30 seconds for my skill to go out of cooldown. I do want to mention one thing. Even though these ships, or at least these science ship as of late, are getting like sensor analysis, it used to be like, you know, a very good ability. Because back in the day when sensor analysis was as a system that was introduced, you didn't have enough DPS to kill the enemy really fast. Nowadays, everybody has like, you know, very high spike damage. So sensor analysis doesn't really feel very good as of late. Unless you're doing like elite or, you know, advanced, then basically sensor analysis is good. But if you're just doing the normal runs, sensor analysis is just, you know, a system that's not that good anymore, because enemies are dying really quickly. And sensor analysis actually is really good whenever you are like stacking it up. But anyway, this is a tactical fleet. Now our own faction flagship is going to warp in. So here we go, 3, 2, 1, click. There it is. There is the, we're getting the Operation Star Cruiser. This is the, this is, wasn't this supposed to be, yeah, it is the Odyssey. Yeah, it is the Odyssey. Cool. I always look through this because there is like a really small gap up here between this thing. So for a minute and a half, this thing is going to aid us in combat. Is it going to follow us? Is it going to move? Is it going to... Okay, it is torpedo spreading this enemies. It is fighting along us. So the trait definitely works. It is good. I like it. You know, honestly, I'm really enjoying this ship. Maneuverability is very good. It is a science ship after all. If you really want to go bonkers and go like, you know, full science mode, you can definitely have enough science abilities right here. Now, these are command bridge officer abilities that I've slotted, but you can also slot just, you know, the normal science stuff. Hazard emitters and, I don't know, tractor beam. Tachyon beam, sorry. If you want to go like that, so you definitely have enough science abilities to do a lot of stuff in the science category. In terms of tactical, the normal traditional DPS, you don't have a lot, to be honest, but then again you have the mode up here to definitely have an extra, or at least you basically switch over from science to tactical. So you can definitely utilize, in my case, attack pattern Omega, because it gives me like healing and stuff like that. That's it, guys, for this review. This ship, I really, really like it. Normally, I state my opinion, and everything that you guys heard in this video, this is just based upon my opinion and how I tend to look at things. 3,000 Zen, definitely worth the ship as it is. Just the normal flat out tier 6 science destroyer. I'm really, really happy with the purchase that I made. And if you guys didn't know a couple of things, after watching this video, you guys might go over and purchase this ship, because it definitely has, you know, in overall perspective, it actually has 8 weapons. So yeah, anyway, that's it for this video, guys. Hope to see you on the next one. For now, I'm gonna say later.